back, everybody, to the Warlord of Espaz Plays Torment, Tides of Numenera, episode 47. Last time we met Medikina, and now we're going through the memories of one of the other cast-offs to figure out where some random doodad is, MacGuffin. So let's find where out the MacGuffin is. But first, what exactly are these hill people, Medikina? My family, Medikina says, and taps her foot impatiently. Impatient with it herself, it seems, because she rushes forward. An Aeon priest named them Tetramorphs, but they don't use that name anymore, or any other. They lived here on this hill for ages. They protect any plains people who sought shelter in the Kulin village. She swallows, closes her eyes, and makes a decision. They're not human. Sometimes they change and go wild. Usually it happens to the young. The old people in other villages call it skin changing, and they call the hill people monsters. She shakes her head. It passes and they change back, but sometimes they leave the village and never turn back. They lose control. People get hurt. With a protective edge in her voice, she finishes. Family. That's what they are. Family people. Just toward the gate. After you. Medikina shrugs and quickly disarms a dozen ancient logs that have long kept the cavern sealed. With a gasp, the gate opens and without waiting, she steps to the you follow. What you find within is no cave tunnel. In fact, there is no stone at all. Rather, a smooth hollow made of greenish phosphorescent ceramic. Under its glow, you and Medikina take greenish phosphorescent ceramic. Sounds like the Necron. Medikina took on the look of You and Medikina take on the look of the unburied dead. There seems to be no side passage, no chamber, merely a single path that curls ever inward, like you are in the shell of some great nautilus. From time to time, the walls are adorned with lifeless ciphers, arcane charts, and even scorch marks, as if some struggle. They tell no tales for you to hear. At last, you reach the tunnel's end, and there on a pedestal before you is what must be the jack, a kind of reed flute that plays an endless, formless song. At once, almost too faint to hear, too haunting to bear. Whether the music is caused by the breeze blowing through the tunnel or by the jack itself is impossible to determine. The ceramic pedestal beneath it, alone of all the devices in the cave, still pulses with living energy. The energy causes the jack to float a fraction of an inch in the air. It doesn't rest on the pedestal so much as hang above it. So, says Medikina, here it is. What do you think the place is? Medikina shrugs. I could do anything. It could be anything. You're the one who always says a personal go crazy trying to understand the world. But from the way she holds a little breath in it as she ends the sentence, it's clear that she can't stop there. Crazy or not, she wants to know. She wants a meaning to it. I think the hill people must have come from here, she says. Or maybe come through here? She shrugs again. But we're not here to find answers. We're here to get that. She points to the jack. Examine the jack.
My studies have borne fruit.
I think somebody just leveled outside. Well, the Jack in the West full wind blown notes in the is what you came for. It is the pedestal that draws your attention first. Hidden within some secret mechanism holds the Jack aloft, untouched and motionless. As for the Jack, you get the same sense that there is more than the music to mirror wind over pipes. Not just tones beyond your hearing range, but perhaps forces beyond sound itself. A deeper harmony that resonates in more than the tiny bones in the inner ear. I can make her grab it or me. Well, she's part of the hill people, so maybe she can grab it. I don't know. Let's see if she'll grab it. Mannequin shoots you a look as sharp as her knives. Then steps forward to the pistols. Sizes up for a moment, then darts her hand onto grab the Jack. The grace and speed of the motion is uncanny, but not enough. Then inserting her hand passes over the pedestal. Energy glances upward, convulsing her body. From which she paralyzed, and as so are you by the sight of it. And then her face wrecked with pain and determination, she forces herself free. She falls to the floor, smoking, groaning, but alive. The Jack still clutches in her Fletcher's grip. Pushing herself to her feet, she mutters, "Thanks for that help. Helps Tash." She gestures back to the wedge in the game. Let's go. They are waiting for you at the gate. A woman you immediately know to be Pez Reckon, and her bodyguard, a half dozen tattooed cast off. With drab armor, mismatched weapons, and the langued readiness of predators. Past them, in the village below, you see the sand knights have arrived and are meeting with Neg and the villagers. Without warning, one of the bodyguards lowers his weapon at Medicaid and fires. But she's already moving and takes a glancing blow. A knife is in her hand as another glaive aims a new device. Before Medicaid can fling her blade, she's frozen, trapped in shimmering energy. Hellersuff aims a tiny cipher at the Jack. Hellers watch, paying you a little mind. What to choose? What are you doing? Running for life while they're occupied. I don't have the MacGuffin. She does, so. Wait, did she give me the MacGuffin? She might have gave me the MacGuffin. I don't remember. Let's attack him. Whatever. Therefore, knowing that you have only an instant until the killer's eyes and arms are turned on you. The instant is shorter than you expect, and it is the last you know. Pain engulfs you, your body is flung backward into the gate. A smoldering room that has just enough consciousness to know that this is the end. And then it's over, and then you're slung over to Tish's body, and Tish's body, and all is dark.
I'm ready to learn something new.
As your consciousness rises from the shadows of the mar, something clicks in your mind, and something has changed deep inside you. But what? Minakina stares at you, the shock painfully obvious on her face. What? What did you do? I remember just cutting me. I saw the holes in my mind. I remember him forcing me to turn around, tearing out my history with his tides. But I have not other memories now. They're real. Just didn't do it. I saw him shot with an energy bolt. He was dead. He couldn't violate me, but he did try, didn't he? Medicina's opinion has improved. She holds her head out in her hands, shaking, her voice becoming thick. The two strands of memory. This is pulling me apart. She looks up at you, tears streaming down her cheeks. No, it's pulling me back together. I remember now. The hole is almost gone. She's, you changed reality. You changed it. She stands drying her eyes with her sleeves. I don't know if you meant to do that, but you've done more than you're part of the deal. You asked about the resonance chamber? I knew it. Mazov's the guy you want. He can fix anything. He might have even helped design the chamber you're talking about. Your best bet is to look for him in the cast-off sanctuary. Malavast. There's a cast-off sanctuary? It's a sanctum, a refuge created by the first and our sire. It shielded from the sorrow, supposedly. She shrugs. Our siblings like to hide there until they can stand each other's company anymore. Personally, I don't think anywhere safe from the sorrow. Not even that place. Great. Where can I find Mel Avast? Word of caution. They won't believe you in Mel Avast. They'll treat you like they treat every new cast off, as a pawn in their games with each other. Look out for that. She walks to her table and unrolls a map of the Scissors Protectorate. You're not going to find it by walking there. Entrance is a circuit known only to Archon here. She points to a spot on the map many kilometers to the northeast of Scissors Cliffs. The Valley of the Dead Heroes. There's a hidden portal in the necropolis. Also memorize that she writes in her 3431. Down on a slip of paper, holds it in front of her eyes for several seconds, then crumples it into her hand. It's a code. It'll make sense when you get to the necropolis. Oh, okay, 3431. You'll need an airship to get to the valley. The ladder over there leads up to the cabin estuary. You should be able to hire a ship without too much difficulty. I can ask you more questions. Making a note. Ooh, levelish. Gonna do some massive leveling after this. Fine, what do you want? Let's see. What's the story about you and the other castoffs? She gives you a long, slow look. You were in the mirror. You saw what happened. I wanted to make a difference, and they pissed me on my hopes. After that debacle, I killed Tesh and fell out with the rest of them. She frowns. The conflict between the first and the Chinning gods was all our siblings, one way or another. I don't want that. I want to make my own way. They weren't pleased, and here I am. No worse for the lack of their company. Yeah. Who is the first cast off? She was, or she claimed to be. She's dead now. She said she'd fight for all of us. They say she was the one who founded Mal Avast for our sakes. Most of our siblings remembered her as a hero. She's pissed in the corner. Most of them never actually knew her. She was driven. I'll give her that. Even with her decaying body. With all its hurts and wounds, she found masks to cover herself. And the strength not to hurt. And she kept plowing on. You can tell me of the chaining god. Brilliant, charming, and ruthlessly self-centered. More blood on his hands than all I ever have. Legend says that he wiped out the Tibet in nearly complete genocide. He left one alive as an object lesson. One of the generals inside in the city to teach his enemies not to cross him. How many castoffs are there anyway? He shrugs. Hundreds, who knows? Supposedly the Tinkercon went to other worlds, spent time in space, slips through dimensions. He always had his spare bodies with him. There could be thousands, millions for all I know. What can you tell me about this place? This is the Cave of Lost Words. It was a thief's hole until the tunnel leading in collapsed 500 to 600 years ago. Is where the scum of the city would slip away from the city guard before there were levies. Before the slave families, the truly desperate lawbreakers fled here when they had no other options. That's the suicide tunnel, she points. The words on the cave walls, those are the final words of people who, with nothing left to lose, etched into the bedrock of the city, burn in and burned out by the hopeless. A fitting metaphor. She looks at you appraisingly. If you question the worth of your life, there's turmoil throughout. These turmoil thoughts are instructive. For a long time, they helped me hang on. I almost wrote my own words there many times. Not that diving off a cliff would have ended me. And then there's a ledge at the end of the tunnel, just in case those words were inspirational. Her crooked grin and resurfaces. The view is always quite nice. How do you find this place? I listened to the stories of old thieves. I went to the Bloom and listened to the stories of Chilla. I made friends with the Stitcher and I asked them if they knew about the place like this. Turns out they did. Would you travel with me? Nah, too many. Let's see. Anything cool I could steal? Yes.
Alright.
Loot. Jinkenrock. And what is that? Oddity. And mirrors. Cool. Anything? No. Nope.
Of course.
Hole of the corner is large, about 2 meters across. It was nearly carved. Clearly carved, but not by human hands. Leads into dark tunnels. You know, it was dug by the Stitcher and leads to the underbelly. I remain right now. I'm still exploring.
Fine.
Fine. Five words of countless men and women are scrawled upon the stone wall. Some apologies to loved ones, while others rage against the injustice or the... I slide a few out, left only their names.
I'm ready.
Interesting. It's good to know. If you have 100% skill to hit, you'll do maximum damage. Deep, 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 deep. Ah, that's how we get down here. Alright. Anything cool?
Yes.
From this height, you can see everything beyond the city of the city's cliffs, plus its chasms extend toward the horizon on the other side of them, at least 50 kilometers. The sea sky stretches between them, perhaps 20 kilometers across it, at its widest. Then the waters widen and swallow the horizon. Look down. The tiers of scissor cliffs spread out to the right, and demolished streets and buildings. To the left is the opening of a dark chasm, turned out flesh cling to the edges like vines. Ocean lies almost 1,000 meters below. Dark and dangerous, scavenging and fishing slopes crawl slowly across the surface. The rooftops of huge homes Yeah, from the cliff surface. But mostly it's cleared down, dropped to the sea. And I really want to jump off, but I know it's stupid. Kind of curious what would happen to. Sheer cliff rises above the edge, that its surface is rough and jagged. There are enough handholds that it looks like climbable, but it won't be easy. Yeah, try to climb. Let's see. Who would be the best at climbing? Maybe him. I'll just have him do it. The cliff face is deceptive holes that look like they'll crumble in your hands to stay firm. While still looking for the truth, it's not crumble like they were made of sand. With careful planning, though, you make it to all the way to the top. So what is this? A welcome blast of wind caresses your face at the cliff's top. You've commanded to follow your path and you blaze for them. Okay, what is glowy orb thing?
Of course.
Most of the cliff top is obscured by the dome of energy. When you get close to it, the air hums and your hand stays on end. I try to see what's inside. The air sizzles as you get closer, popping across your skin like invisible jumping beetles. When you are within arm's reach, a control interface appears in the air in front of you. It has a glowing circle with strange symbols floating on the edge of and a vertical bar next to it. When you step back again, the interface disappears. Whatever energy forms this dome is completely opaque. You can't see anything through it. Oddly, though, you can see the shadows of cliffs birds on the other side. Study the interface. I are good at this. Alright. Oh, I gotta remember to level my characters up. The circle is likely a place to put one's hand or face. Probably the former, since the heat from the dome might burn your face. Presumably someone with the proper authority could open the dome by using the holographic bar on the side of the... as a kind of latch. The symbols around the circle are unfamiliar, suggesting the installation is very old, perhaps predating the truth. Whoever created this dome then wanted to keep what was inside a secret from anyone except those to whom he or she has given access. Try the interface. As soon as you place your hand in the circle, the symbols light up and spin rapidly. Apparently, you have the authority to enter. You slide your other hand up to the bar of the side and the interface disappears. Air cools immediately in the dome phase until it is gone entirely. Ha. Huh. That are you. Before I go any further, let's level. Alright. Can add extra effort, increase edge, increase stat pools. I don't need increased stat pools, my stats are pretty high. I could increase how many free bars I get. Yeah, I'm gonna do that for intelligence. 2 free bars. That sounds good. Oh, I'm also up to the next level too. Jeez, got a lot of XP for that. Alright, you leveled. Let's see. Let's increase your intelligence pool. Confirm. You leveled, Mr. Meat Shield. You have 2 effort. Let's increase your might. There. And Rin. I can only do extra effort. All right. Yes. Cloak of all. To other party members, gain all other persons stealth, 5 evasion, plus 5% in esoteric attacks. Sweet. Green level cipher. Invert. Remove all negative effect health. So she can, like, heal people. Yeah, sure. She's not really my cipher user anyway. Let's see. The healing. I don't need you to do lore because everyone else does. You don't need cipher use, perception, running. Let's go with quick fingers because you are kind of our quick finger lass. Alright. Now you have some nice stats. That's going to be helpful, y'all.
Do you ever think before you do any of the things you do?
Never. Thinking slows your mind. Always act before thinking. And then act again. Do it right. Never have to think at all.
Alright, I'm going to leave it here. And next time, we'll discover what this device does. Well, won't that be fun? So until next time, remember, brace the chaos or you'll go mad. Bye!